Hi, welcome to the new session in this machine learning course. So from this lecture onwards, I want to start a very beautiful algorithm that is naive Bayes. So this is an algorithm which is based on the method of probabilities. Okay. So now let's quickly look at what naive Bayes exactly is. So in naive Bayes, this Bayes stands for a very popular theorem from probability, that is Bayes theorem. Okay, Bayes theorem. I'm sure many of you might have already heard about this theorem. So in this session, let's quickly try to look at what Bayes theorem exactly is. Okay, if I write PA, okay, so we already know what PA is. PA basically means probability that event A is going to happen. Okay, what is the probability that event A might happen? Similarly, I have a thing known as PA given B. Okay, what do we mean by PA given B? PA given B means that what is the probability that event A is going to happen given that B has already happened. Okay, what is the probability that event A might happen given that B has already happened? So this is what conditional probability is. So Bayes theorem is basically a formula for solving conditional probability equations. Okay, yeah. So to understand Bayes theorem, let's quickly look at a very simple example. Let's say we have two dices. Okay, we have two dices. I'm sure you already know what dice is. A dice is basically a cube which has numbers from 1 to 6 written all over its faces. Okay, so let's say we have two cubes, that is two dices. If I throw two dices on a table, what is the probability that both of them are going to have 6 on its faces? Okay, on the top face, that both are going to be 6. Okay, what are the total sample space? What I mean by sample space, that what are the total number of outcomes? So total number of outcomes are, if I have a first dice and a second dice, so I might have 1-1 on both of them, 1-2 on both of them, 1-3, and so on. I might have 1-6, and similarly I might have till 6-6. So basically there can be 36 possible outcomes. If someone asks me what is the probability that both are going to be 6, both 6, I can clearly say my probability is going to be 1/36, okay? Because out of this 36, I have only one of this outcome which has 6 on it. Basically, favorable outcomes are 1 and total outcomes are 36. So basically, PA, that is P both 6, is going to be 1/36, okay? So, but if someone asks me, what is the probability that both are going to be 6, both are going to be 6, given at least one of them is 6? Okay, at least 1/6. Okay, so I hope you are understanding. Basically, someone is asking me what is the probability that both of them are going to be 6 given that at least one of them is definitely 6. Okay, so how I am going to solve this? So what I'm going to do is, out of these 36 outcomes, I have to find out in how many outcomes there is at least 1/6. Okay, so if I carefully notice, I will get to know that there are 11 such outcomes. Okay, so let me just list down these outcomes. So basically these are the 6 outcomes: 1/6, 2/6, 3/6, 4/6, 5/6, and then we have 6/1, 6/2, 6/3, 6/4, 6/5, and 6/6. So basically 6 over here and 5 outcomes over here. Total 11 outcomes are there in which at least one of them is a 6. Okay, so from this 11 outcome, there is one such outcome that both are going to be 6. So for this conditional probability, probability of both 6 given at least one of them is 6 is going to be 1/11. Okay, so our answer for this is going to be 1/11. Okay, so we have solved this, right? But there is another theorem which I have already talked about, that is Bayes theorem, which will help us solving this 1/11. Okay, how we can do that? So that theorem says basically P A given B is equal to P B given A into P A by P B. Okay, so basically this is the formula for Bayes theorem. Okay, we have already solved our LHS P A given B. Now let's try and check if RHS is also giving us the same 1/11 answer. So see, what we are basically trying to do is, we are basically trying to check if Bayes theorem is giving us the correct answer for this simple question. Okay, so in the next session, I will basically discuss what naive exactly is and how Bayes theorem can be used in machine learning, okay, in our naive Bayes algorithm. Okay, so let's continue. So if I solved the same thing using my RHS, I would have simply, instead of writing this, I could have written this probability at least 1 6, okay, at least 1 6, given both are 6, both 6, okay. Basically, we have inverted it because P A given B, and in the RHS we have P B given A. So, I have just inverted both of them, okay, into probability of both 6, okay, divided by probability of at least 1 6, at least 1 6, okay. So, just consider this first part, probability of at least 1 6 given both 6. What this exactly means? If I tell you that after rolling the dice, someone comes and tells me that both of them were 6 and ask me, now tell me what is the probability that at least one of them was 6. So, it is obviously going to be 1, right? Because he has already told me that both of them are 6. So, at least one of them 6 is definitely 1. So, there is at least 1 6 over there because I know that both of them are 6. Okay. So, probability of my first part is definitely 1. This thing is 1. And for calculating my probability of both 6, I already know that is 1 by 36, okay. And then probability of at least 1 6, that should be 11 by 36. At least 1 6 because there are total 11 outcomes in which there is at least 1 6 and total sample space is 36. So, simply removing 36, so our answer is 1 by 11 using RHS of our Bayes theorem. So, basically we have simply verified the Bayes theorem through a simple example, okay. So, in the next session, we will discuss how Bayes theorem can be used in machine learning, okay. So, okay, I will see you in the next session. Thank you.